So now that we've introduced the projection operator, let's see where we are. We began with the original evolution law of the fine-grained cellular automata, f of x, y, and z. We then realized that if we wanted to skip two time steps in the future, we would have to have more arguments here. So we rewrote that as f hat as a function of x hat, y hat, and z hat. What this function does is it takes the state of the system here and evolves it two steps forward. Instead of writing each of these grid cells separately, we write them as a combined variable x hat, y hat, and z hat. Now, the relationship between this f and this f hat and this f hat here is totally deterministic. Once you tell me this, I can work out this here. The problem is that this f hat is no longer in the same model class as this. All I've told you is that when you coarse grain in time, you get a different model. But there's really no good way to relate these to say, like, oh, this has become more or less complex, this has become more or less interesting, this parameter has changed. We can't, for example, place these as dots in some phase space and show how models move as you coarse grain them in time. But now we have the projection operator. And so we can write something like this. We can project down the input supercells. We can coarse grain the spatial state of the system. And then we can talk about the function g that evolves these coarse grained variables forward in time. So we can think about these two different operations on a diagram that you can imagine as, well, is sometimes called a commuting diagram. Down here, we have the fine-grained system state specified by three variables, x hat, y hat, and z hat. And of course, these variables here expand, if you wanted to, into a list of, let's call them xi's, I from 1 to 6 for that little patch of the finite state, sorry, of the cellular automata. So this is at time t equals 1. This is time t equals 1. Then we can get the fine-grained system at time t equals 2. And then we can get the fine-grained system at t equals 3. With the projection operator, I can take this set of system states here and map them to a set of projections, p hat, or p of x hat, p of y hat, and p of z hat. And then I can evolve that coarse grain system forward using some function g. Now what g does is it takes in three binary variables and spits out a single binary variable. So g is somewhere in the model class of cellular automata. And out the other side, I get a new set of variables. Or rather, I get the evolved state of the system at the coarse grain level. From here to here, we just require f and f. We wrote down this function f hat that gets you there. It takes all these variables in at once. And so f hat takes x hat, y hat, and z hat. And so going along the bottom, we evolve the supercells. Going up, we project the initial configuration of the supercells. Going right up here, we evolve that projected configuration forward in time. And so now we can compare what happens if you coarse grain and evolve to what happens if you evolve and then coarse grain. So our goal now will be given a particular cellular automata f at the fine grain level. Can we find a projection operator p and a coarse-grained evolution operator g, such that if you go along this path, it's equivalent to going along that path? In other words, can we make this diagram, in the technical language, commute? Notice that this function here, g, takes in three binary variables and spits out a single binary variable, and so it is, in fact, in this same CA model class, it is indeed one of the 256 of the cellular automata that we can think about to begin with. If we go with this projection operator here, it may even be the case that we can find a P such that the G that makes this diagram compute, or this make this diagram commute, is equal to the F. In other words, if we skip a step and blur the spatial dimension in the right way, we may actually get back the same evolution operator. It's a little bit like saying, if you zoom out and squint, do you get back the same process with which you began?